It is the deepest area in the entire ocean and one of the most unexplored areas in the world. It is so extremely difficult to get there that the number of people who have visited it is less than the number of people who have set foot on the moon's surface. We refer to the Mariana Trench, a mysterious and dangerous place that, despite being on our planet, is more hostile to humans than the moon. Do you want to know what this place is like and why so few people have visited it? Stay with us to find out. The deepest place in the world. The Mariana Trench is the deepest place on Earth. It is located in the western Pacific Ocean, east of the Mariana Islands. This underwater abyss is one of the most enigmatic and least explored places on the planet because the trench is approximately 2,550 kilometers long and 69 kilometers wide. Still, its most impressive feature is its depth. The trench was discovered in the late 19th century by the expedition of the British Navy ship HMS Challenger, which made a series of measurements in the ocean between 1872 and 1876. During this expedition, the Mariana Trench was first identified as the deepest part of the ocean. However, the true magnitude of its depth was not fully understood until decades later, when advances in measurement technology allowed for greater accuracy. The deepest point of the Mariana Trench is the Challenger Deep, which is approximately 10,994 meters deep. In perspective, if Mount Everest were placed at the bottom of the Challenger Deep, its summit would still be submerged under more than 2,000 meters of water. The pressure at this point is more than 1,000 times the atmospheric pressure at sea level, making it one of the most extreme environments known to humans. First expeditions to the Challenger Deep. Reaching the bottom of the Mariana Trench has been one of the most formidable challenges in human exploration's history. The first successful human crewed mission to the Challenger Deep was conducted in 1960 by Swiss oceanographer Jacques Picard and U.S. Navy Lieutenant Don Walsh. This historic descent was made aboard the Bathyscape Trieste, an underwater vessel designed to withstand the colossal pressures of the deep ocean. The Trieste was an engineering masterpiece of the time. Equipped with a steel sphere with walls 12.7 centimeters thick, the Bathyscape was designed to withstand the pressure equivalent to more than 1,000 atmospheres at nearly 11,000 meters deep. The sphere was only 2.6 meters in diameter, which offered minimal space for its two occupants. However, this was enough for an expedition to the bottom of the trench. On January 23, 1960, Picard and Walsh began their descent on the Trieste, an operation that took almost 5 hours to reach the bottom. During the dive, the explorers experienced incredible pressure and total darkness conditions, as sunlight cannot penetrate beyond 1,000 meters deep. The descent was slow and dangerous. At one point, the Trieste suffered a crack in one of its vision panels due to the immense water pressure. Despite the challenges, Picard and Walsh reached the bottom of the Challenger Abyss and remained there for about 20 minutes. During this brief time, they observed the seabed and noticed the presence of life, which was a surprising find since it was thought that no living thing could survive at those depths and under such crushing pressure. After their short stay, they began their ascent, which took approximately 3.5 hours. This monumental achievement proved that exploring the ocean's most extreme depths was possible, but it also underscored how difficult and dangerous it was. If they had stayed longer or had the slightest mechanical failure in the submarine, the crew members would have died. Only a handful of people have returned to the Challenger Abyss since the Trieste expedition, and all have used advanced technologies that continue to evolve. In 2012, filmmaker James Cameron soloed on the deep-sea Challenger submersible, a craft specifically designed for the mission. Unlike the Trieste, the deep-sea Challenger was equipped with cameras and sample collection systems, allowing for a more detailed seafloor exploration. Cameron stayed in the depths for nearly 3 hours, making scientific observations and documenting his experience. In 2019, explorer Victor Vescovo made a further descent, this time on the DSV Limiting Factor Submersible. This ship, part of the Five Deeps project, was designed to be reusable and withstand multiple dives at great depths, marking a significant advancement in underwater exploration technology. At the time this video was created, 8 people, mainly scientific explorers and millionaires, had visited the bottom of the Mariana Trench. By comparison, 12 people have walked on the moon's surface. This means that the number of people who have gone to the moon is larger than the number who have visited the bottom of the Challenger Deep in the Mariana Trench. This is mainly because there is only space between the Earth and the moon, while to reach the bottom of the Challenger Deep, there's a lot of water that increases the pressure as we submerge. The pressure at these depths is so extreme that equipment failure could be catastrophic. In addition, absolute darkness and temperatures close to freezing makes this an extremely hostile environment for humans. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Life in the deep. Despite the seemingly uninhabitable conditions, the Mariana Trench is home to a variety of unique life forms adapted to the environment's extremes. The discovery of life in these depths has been one of the most astonishing discoveries in ocean exploration, challenging preconceived notions about the limits of life on Earth. Among the inhabitants of the Mariana Trench are organisms known as extremophiles, which can survive in conditions that would be deadly to most other forms of life. These include bacteria and archaea that thrive in environments with high pressure, low temperature, and no sunlight. Some of these bacteria have evolved the ability to metabolize chemicals such as methane and hydrogen sulfide rather than relying on photosynthesis for energy. In addition to microorganisms, more complex life forms have been discovered in these depths. For example, fish species such as Pseudoliparis suarez, commonly known as the Mariana snailfish, have been observed living at depths greater than 8,000 meters. These fish have evolved unique physiological adaptations, such as reinforced cell membranes and particular proteins, allowing them to withstand extreme pressure. Another notable inhabitant of the Mariana Trench is the Xenophyophoria, a giant single-celled organism that can reach sizes of up to 20 centimeters. These organisms are found in seafloor sediments and are characterized by their ability to tolerate extremely high levels of heavy metals, which would be toxic to other life forms. The discovery of these creatures has been achieved primarily through uncrewed expeditions using remotely operated vehicles, or ROVs, and automated submersibles. These vehicles are equipped with high-definition cameras, robotic arms, and sample collection tools, allowing scientists to study these organisms in their natural environment without exposing themselves to the dangers of descending to the bottom of the Mariana Trench. This unique and little understood ecosystem is a testament to life's resilience, which has found ways to thrive in even the most inhospitable places on our planet. However, life in the Mariana Trench is also vulnerable to human impacts, such as pollution from plastics and other debris, reaching even these remote depths. Why is it so difficult to get there? Exploring the Mariana Trench presents unique and extraordinary challenges, making it one of the most dangerous and elusive places on Earth. It's often said that sending a human crewed mission to the moon is more accessible than going to the bottom of the Mariana Trench, and there are several reasons for this comparison. First, the pressure in the Challenger Deep is about 1,100 times the atmospheric pressure at sea level. At these depths, any mistake in the design or construction of equipment can have disastrous consequences. Even the slightest imperfection in a submersible's hull can cause an implosion under extreme pressure, killing occupants instantly. In addition, the Mariana Trench is an environment of total darkness due to the lack of sunlight, which further complicates operations. Another factor is temperature. At these depths, the water temperature is nearly freezing, adding another challenge for life support equipment and systems. Low temperatures can affect the performance of the submersible's materials and mechanisms, increasing the risk of technical failures. Unlike space missions, where extreme temperatures are also a challenge, these factors combine with crushing pressure in the Mariana Trench, creating a highly hostile environment. In addition, exploring the Mariana Trench is logistically complicated. Missions require large support ships on the surface, from which submersibles are launched and retrieved. These vessels must be equipped with cranes, advanced communication systems, and rescue equipment in case of emergency. The distance from the surface to the bottom is so great that any human crewed mission needs considerable time to descend and ascend, limiting the time explorers can spend on the bottom and increasing risks. However, perhaps the most significant barrier is the cost of these missions. It is extremely expensive to develop, construct, and operate a submersible capable of withstanding the conditions in the Challenger Abyss. While a human-crewed mission to the Moon is very costly, the vast difference is that the U.S. government funded the only operated lunar program in history, the Apollo program. In contrast, expeditions to the Mariana Trench have been primarily funded by entrepreneurs and the private sector. In terms of budget, expeditions to the Mariana Trench cost much less than a manned mission to the Moon. The difference is that missions to the Moon had an unlimited budget, while expeditions to the Mariana Trench have had more austere budgets and have been adjusted to what the private sector can afford. Another aspect to consider is communication. During a lunar mission, astronauts can maintain continuous contact with Earth, and radio signals only take a few seconds to travel between the two celestial bodies. In contrast, deep within the Mariana Trench, communication is much more complicated because radio waves don't travel well through the water. Missions must rely on cables and acoustic systems that are slower and less reliable, increasing insulation and risk during operations. Finally, scientific research is the reason why more people have been on the Moon than at the bottom of the Mariana Trench. If we focus only on scientific research, we can choose manned or autonomous missions with robots to investigate the Mariana Trench and the Moon. Uncrewed missions with robots are cheaper if you want to go to the Moon or the bottom of the Mariana Trench. However, there is a vast difference between sending a robot to the Moon and the Mariana Trench. That difference is that sending a robot to the Mariana Trench is hundreds of times cheaper than sending a robot to the Moon. The reason is that to send a robot to the Moon or anywhere off Earth, it is necessary to mount it on a rocket, which is very expensive. Meanwhile, to send a robot to the Mariana Trench, you must condition it to withstand the overwhelming pressure of the water, and that's it. In addition, getting a robot to the Moon safely is extremely tricky because it must automatically perform all the calculations and necessary conditions to land on the Moon without crashing. In contrast, the Apollo program's human-crewed missions to the Moon carried experienced pilots who could see the terrain they would land on with their own eyes and make critical decisions during the Moon landing so that everything would go smoothly. As we can see, the human's ability to successfully land a spacecraft on the Moon is far superior to that of more modern robots. In short, if you want to investigate the Mariana Trench, you can't send a robot at a relatively low cost without endangering anyone's life. While sending a robot to the Moon is highly costly, with the risk of the mission failing. In other words, sending humans is much more reliable and cheaper if we want to explore the Moon, while sending robots is better for exploring the Mariana Trench. That is why more people have gone to the Moon than gone to the bottom of the Mariana Trench. Now we want to know your opinion. Tell us, do you think underwater technology will advance so much in the future that going to the bottom of the Mariana Trench will be much easier than going to the Moon? Let us know what you think in the comments below. And now check out one of our other videos about the Mariana Trench.